The salmon strategy was released by the governor in January of 2024. It identifies six priorities for restoring salmon habitat in California. Modernizing hatcheries is one priority in the salmon strategy that's being implemented here today. The purpose of the Fall Creek Hatchery is to bridge the gap between the baseline of dams in versus dams out. So now that the dams are out of the Klamath River, we want to ensure that the populations of salmon in the system are going to be enough to propagate self-sustaining populations.
The new Fall Creek Hatchery was established in roughly November of 2023, so just last year. There are two species of fish that are reared at Fall Creek Hatchery. Those are the Chinook salmon and Coho salmon. This is our first return year after dam removal at Fall Creek Hatchery, and we're excited to see the numbers of adults that we're seeing returning up here for our first year. Some of the adult fall run Chinook that we're seeing returning to Fall Creek Hatchery were reared here as yearlings 3 years ago, back in 2020, at the Fall Creek facility, before the new facility was built.
We have more resilient fish being produced due to water quality improvements with the water that's raising these fish. We're releasing various life histories, so that gives the fish an opportunity to out-migrate at different times of year, mimicking what we would see in river naturally.
We're using a volitional release strategy. We're pulling the screens and some boards, allowing the fish to voluntarily swim out on their own into Fall Creek. They can get familiar with their surroundings. They can start getting used to the new food sources that are available to them and just kind of acclimate to the water, to their new environment. We expect these fish that we released today, the yearling fall run Chinook in November 2024, to return in the next 3 years.
There's also unique things about this facility that I think are creating more resilient fish. There's a genetic pairing program for coho salmon, so they're avoiding that genetic vortex through parental-based tagging. And so that's state-of-the-art. That's happening here at Fall Creek.
November 13th of 2024, we had our first coho salmon return to the Fall Creek Hatchery. It would be the first coho salmon to return to Fall Creek before the dams were put up. Once staff identified there were coho salmon returning to Fall Creek Hatchery, they collected those coho salmon and a genetic sample was collected from each individual adult. Those adults were put in holding units until we received the results of the genetic samples back. And those genetic samples will tell us which pairs of males and females that we can spawn together that are the least related pairs.
We also have photo period specific lights. They're trying to mimic the photo period outside. So as they're, you know, handling fish and producing these out migrating fish, they're getting used to the photo period that they'll experience once they're released. So these are creating stronger, more resilient fish. Fall Creek Hatchery is essential during this bridge period of dams in versus dams out, using refined management techniques in hatcheries.